Hello, my name is Dr. John Jernigan, and I'm a medical officer at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC. Infections are the second leading cause of death among hemodialysis patients, and many of these infections are preventable. The following video segments will review recommended practices based on published evidence and best practices that you can use to help prevent infections and keep your patients safe. Hand hygiene is one of the most important ways to prevent the spread of infections. Hand hygiene means either washing your hands with soap and water or using an alcohol-based hand rub. When your hands are contaminated with blood, other body fluids, or are visibly dirty, wash them with soap and water. If your hands aren't visibly dirty, you can use an alcohol-based hand rub instead. There are many times when it's necessary for you to perform hand hygiene, including before and after you provide care for a patient, before you draw, inject, or infuse a medication or solution, before you cannulate a fistula or graft, or access a catheter, after you touch blood, body fluids, mucous membranes, or use materials such as dressings or spent dialysate, after you touch medical equipment or other items at the dialysis station, and after you remove your gloves. Changing your gloves is important to protect your patients from infections. Examples of when you should remove your gloves and put on new gloves include after contacting a potentially contaminated site before moving to a clean site, after contact with blood or body fluids, and after completing tasks at one patient station and moving to another station. Remember, two easy ways to reduce the chances of spreading an infection are to perform hand hygiene and change your gloves. Safely handling and caring for a patient's vascular access is vital for preventing infections, particularly in patients who use a catheter, because the risk of infection is highest in these patients. This segment will teach you ways to follow aseptic technique, which means taking great care not to contaminate the catheter during connection or disconnection procedures. It's also important to follow aseptic technique while caring for the catheter exit site, which includes the following steps. While wearing other appropriate personal protective equipment, or PPE, perform hand hygiene and put on a new, clean pair of gloves. Remove the catheter dressing. Evaluate the catheter exit site for signs of infection like redness or swelling. Remove your gloves, perform hand hygiene, and put on a new, clean pair of gloves. Apply chlorhexidine to the exit site using mild friction. Let the exit site air dry naturally and do not touch it. Apply an antimicrobial ointment that is compatible with the catheter material. Apply clean dressing to the exit site, being careful not to touch the exit site. And remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. To properly perform a catheter scrub the hub procedure during connection, use the following steps. Put on a gown and a face shield. Use a mask if required by facility policy. Perform hand hygiene and put on a new clean pair of gloves. Some centers may choose to use sterile gloves. Make sure to clamp both limbs of the catheter to prevent an air embolus. Remove the caps. While keeping the catheter clamped, apply antiseptic to each end of the catheter, which are the hubs, using a new sterile antiseptic pad for each hub. Scrub the end and sides of each hub with friction, ensuring that all debris is removed. To maintain aseptic technique, let the catheter limbs and hubs air dry naturally. Do not touch the cleaned hubs and do not set the hubs down. Connect the catheter to the blood lines using aseptic technique. Unclamp the catheter only after it's connected. And remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. If any of your patients use a needleless connector device on their catheter, you should follow the manufacturer's recommendations for that type of device. When the patient has completed treatment, the same care should be taken using the scrub the hub procedure for catheter disconnection. While wearing other appropriate PPE, perform hand hygiene and put on a new clean pair of gloves. Make sure to clamp the catheter and then disconnect the catheter from the blood lines using aseptic technique. Once again, apply antiseptic to the ends or hubs of each catheter. Use a new sterile antiseptic pad for each hub. Scrub the end and sides of each hub with friction, ensuring that all debris is removed. Let the catheter limbs and hubs air dry naturally. Do not touch the cleaned hubs and do not set the hubs down. Attach new sterile caps using aseptic technique and remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. You should scrub the hub anytime there is a line disconnection or reversal. Following the scrub the hub protocol and paying close attention to aseptic technique will help prevent bloodstream infections. Safely handling or caring for a patient's vascular access is important to prevent infections. This segment will teach you ways to follow aseptic technique, which means taking great care to not contaminate the fistula or graft site during cannulation and decannulation. This video segment does not apply to patients who use buttonhole access. Here's how to perform the cannulation procedure for patients with fistulas or grafts. Patients are encouraged to wash their own access site if possible. Clean the site with soap and water if the patient hasn't already done so. Put on a gown and a face shield. Perform hand hygiene and put on a new clean pair of gloves. Assess the vascular access site for signs of infection such as redness or swelling. If there are signs of infection, do not cannulate without further investigation. If the site is clear, apply skin antiseptic to the site and allow it to dry. To maintain aseptic technique, let the antiseptic air dry naturally and do not touch the clean site. Perform cannulation and be careful not to contaminate the area that has been cleansed. Secure the needles and connect to the bloodlines using aseptic technique. And remove gloves and perform hand hygiene. When the patient has completed treatment, here are the steps for fistula or graft decannulation. Put on a gown and a face shield. Assist the patient with gloving if they will be compressing their access site. Perform hand hygiene and put on a new clean pair of gloves. Disconnect from the bloodlines using aseptic technique. Activate the needle retraction device and remove needles using aseptic technique. Dispose of the needles in a proper sharps container. Apply clean gauze or a bandage to the access site and compress it with clean gloved hands. Both the staff and patient should remove gloves and perform hand hygiene. Following these steps will reduce the risk of an access-related infection. Dialysis staff must perform routine disinfection of the dialysis station to prevent the spread of infections. The following steps are intended to be used when there is no visible blood on surfaces at the dialysis station. When blood or other soil is visible, surfaces must be cleaned prior to disinfection. Here are the actions you should take before beginning routine disinfection of the dialysis station. While wearing a gown and gloves, disconnect and take down the used blood tubing and dialyzer from the dialysis machine. Discard tubing and dialyzers in a leak-proof container or remove dialyzer from the station in a leak-proof manner. And check for visible soil or blood on surfaces. All visible blood should be cleaned immediately. The following actions may be performed in any order. Ensure that the priming bucket has been emptied. Discard all single-use supplies. Move any reusable supplies to an area where they will be disinfected before being stored or returned to a dialysis station. Ensure that the patient has left the dialysis station. Finally, remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. Now here are the steps for routine disinfection of the empty dialysis station when there is no visible soil or blood on surfaces. While wearing a gown, put on clean gloves. Apply disinfectant to all surfaces in the dialysis station using a firm wiping motion. Make sure that surfaces of the station are visibly wet with disinfectant. Also, disinfect all surfaces of the emptied priming bucket. Let all surfaces air dry naturally. Avoid recontaminating surfaces by keeping any used or potentially contaminated items away from the disinfected surfaces. Finally, remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. Do not bring the next patient or any supplies for the next treatment to the dialysis station until all of these steps have been completed. Following these steps for routine disinfection will help prevent the spread of infections.